Hello friends, so in this video I have come up with a review on courses related to mechanical engineering. And so a couple of weeks back I had uploaded a video regarding reviews on course which are disciplinary electives for students in our institute. And upon response to that, many of my friends and juniors have requested to give reviews about compulsory courses also, so they get a head start while understanding the course, learning, and how to approach the course to get better marks. So this video is regarding some study tips and overall review about a course. So the first course I'm taking up over here is manufacturing process. It is also called sometimes as production techniques, and there can be different names also, but this is a very core course of mechanical engineering students curriculum. And let's start with that. So in this video I'm going to cover the major topics which are included in the course, the major study resources, or not to say major study resources, I would give you some study resources which I followed during my study time and which gave me a very good grip on the subject. Then the evaluation scheme, or what marks or how can you get good marks, and some fields of application and what are linked other fields where or which you should study if you liked or got interested in this subject. So manufacturing process can be short formed as MP. Generally an engineering student does that. And it is also called as production techniques, as I said earlier, and which is having a short form of PT. So we earlier in the mechanical engineering curriculum may have production techniques, two courses of production technique 1, 2, or in manufacturing process, we may have advanced manufacturing process also. So in this video, I'm going to give you an overall picture of all the manufacturing processes. So I'm not going to differentiate with manufacturing process and advanced manufacturing process or production techniques 1 and production techniques 2. The names may get changed in some years, but I'm going to give you an overall picture of all the things included in these courses. So let's go there. And this is a core course for manufacturing domain. So if you have not seen a video in which I have explained various or three major domains of mechanical engineering, then you should go and watch so you have an overall idea of where you want to go in, which field or which domain interests you. So that may help you. So if you find manufacturing process as a course interesting, there is a reason why. So that may be a reason that you have seen such processes earlier, you have more hands-on experience, or you have some practical experience doing some of the things like cutting or grinding, welding, etc., or you have seen them closely repeatedly. That's why you may be interested in this course, or after learning you get some interest. So that is one of the reason, and be hold of that reason, because that's a very good practical, having a practical experience is an advantage. And manufacturing processes have been developing since long last. So we can see since last three centuries, we have been involved in manufacturing from raw material to what our finished products are. So there are a lot of developments, there are a lot of researches, and there is a lot of change which has happened. So until and unless we study the subject from the professor, we'll not understand what was our old technique, what has happened, how the things have evolved. So professor knows what are important subjects, what are important topics, what is not important, what has taken or been ruled out from industry. So that's not important for us to study. So professor would know what is right now going on in the industry, and hence he'll help us or she'll help us to take better use of our time. And in general, as I said, manufacturing process is a very vast topic. So it is classified into two major parts: conventional manufacturing processes and unconventional manufacturing processes. So let's start with the major topics which are included in this subject. So the first topic, or you should have some basic knowledge of material properties. So we'll start with the things which are related to metals and non-metals first, or solids in general. So we should know the basic material properties, the stress-strain relationships of those material properties. And there are multiple failure models also, which you may have studied in mechanics of solid subject or machine design subject, or they will be also taught in manufacturing process also. So these failure models are important to understand where my material will fail. Then we can actually go into the manufacturing side. So first we may have a topic related to conventional manufacturing processes for metal. So manufacture means to make. Manufacture means to make. So first we want to make from the raw material. So there are multiple processes such as casting and forming process. So in forming, there are multiple processes such as rolling, extrusion, forging, drawing, bending, punching, and blanking. So I have tried to be as much exact, and all the things which are included in forming, I have listed them down over here. So I'm not going to skip things. I'll try not to skip and write, etc. Then we have conventional machining processes or reworking of the metal. So once we have made that, the thing which we have made, there may not be exactly what we required as the finished good. So we may need to rework on it. So then there are orthogonal and unorthogonal machining processes. So it's unorthogonal over here. Then we have economics of machining. So that is a very major topic, which we need to understand how and what are the cost of making process, reworking on it, cost related to marketing, cost related to tools, cost related to time, labor, etc. All the things are included. So if you are from economics background also, these things may interest you. And the machining processes related to reworking of a metal are shaping, planning, drilling, cutting, milling, grinding, turning, and boring. The dot 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 is still over there, or etc. still over there, because over here also I have tried to be as much extensive and write down all, include all the processes I know or I have studied. But as and when time passes, there are more and more developments going, researches are happening. Hence, this list will grow and developing, and things will add up. That's why I have put three dots. Then the second part would be where we handle polymers or plastics. So first we need to understand the material properties related to plastic. So material properties for metals included hardness, toughness, and related yield strength, etc. So correspondingly, in polymers also there are other material properties such as melt flow index, density, etc. So those things we need to understand. Then we have conventional manufacturing processes for polymers. So these things are in picture since last 50, 70 years. So hence they are still called as conventional manufacturing process, where we have extrusion, blow molding, rotational molding, injection molding. So these are the four major things. There are still other developments happening. So, and rotational molding to say is the most updated one, where we can make big plastic products such as with what we see as syntex or big underground water tanks or overhead roof water tanks of 1,000 liter, 2,000 liter, 5,000 liters. So those are made from rotational molding. And we have not seen or we have not studied anything or any processes which are used for reworking on polymers. So that's maybe because the cost involved in reworking of those polymers is or would be more than the cost of raw material plus manufacturing. So it's not worth it to invest money, time, and efforts, resources on reworking of those polymer materials or products. Instead, we can make a new one from raw material itself, from scratch itself. Then we have joining processes. So those joining processes are majorly related to metals and less for polymers. And joining processes includes the main welding, and the other modified ways of welding are there, such as resistant welding, electric welding, etc. And then we have fasteners, which are screws, nut, bolts, etc. And then we go to unconventional part. So this is the second part, which may be said as production techniques 2 or advanced manufacturing process. where we have unconventional manufacturing machining processes. So these are reworking processes where we have ultrasonic. So we use unconventional sources of energy. Earlier, the conventional sources of energy was used, where we use the force, the actual force, physical force. Over here, we use the energy from ultrasound. We use plasma arc energy, electron beam energy, chemical energy, electric energy, etc. Hence, they are called as unconventional machining process. Then we have a major and interesting topic of pneumatics and electro-pneumatics. So this is where the control system thing would come in, where we press some button and something happens at a distance. A cylinder may expand, a cylinder may contract, a valve may open and close. So those things using a push button. So if we can press things over here and something happens 1 kilometer far, so that's happened. Or those are the things included in pneumatics and electro-pneumatics. Then a major topic is computer-controlled manufacturing or computer-aided manufacturing, which is called as CAM, or numerical control things. So we have computer-numerical control. CNC is computer, numerical control lathe, CNC milling, coordinate measuring machine, vertical milling machine, etc. are there. And we should have an understanding of limit, fits and tolerance. So that means if we are manufacturing a part, obviously if we are making an assembly, multiple parts need to come. So a part is coming from a company A, a second part is coming from company B, and they need to fit. So a first company cannot make a part exactly at 50 mm. So over there, some tolerance is involved, such as it can make some 1% tolerance is allowed to that 50 mm. And hence the concept of limit fits and tolerance is very important. And the most recent topic, which we can see in the development phase, is additive manufacturing, where we have powder metallurgy thing, where we use powder and make parts from it. Some of the sources which I use. So the textbook, which is Amitabha Ghosh, is excellent. We can study theory from it. We can study examples and solve questions. Those are very helpful and they may appear in exams also. Then we have class notes. So if professor is teaching and he is excellent in derivations and he is giving his inputs from industrial experience, that may be a worth to note down in your class notes, and that may help in your interviews also. And my notes are also available on my YouTube channel. So I have made the notes of half of the manufacturing processes which have been included. So if we go to my channel, over there in playlist, I have included a complete playlist which is related to products and techniques. So over there, the topics related to the second part of manufacturing process are there. So unconventional manufacturing processes are explained, CNC, lathe, everything is explained in this, and I will keep on adding more and more videos as I gain knowledge and make notes. Fine. And for evaluation scheme, so a professor may give you some project, some assignment to work on, where you need to get clear on how to make a process and provide your comments, etc. Otherwise, there may be a lot of formulas involved, but you should not worry about the long formulas. Generally, the professor would provide all the formulas required to solve a problem in the question paper itself, or you would be allowed to take some a formula sheet with you for the exam if it is a closed book exam. And so you should focus more on understanding the concept and get a complete clarity of what the processes are, because some of the processes which are described over here, this process is using this different energy source, they are very common, have the working principle may be common. So you should have a clear cut idea of what's the difference exactly. And over here also, the processes which I listed, rolling extrusion, so they have a small difference. So you should have a complete and clear cut idea of where the differences are and what's their characteristic processes make. Okay. And the last thing, the field, so it is involved in quality control engineering, industrial engineering, manufacturing domain, as I said earlier. And there are a lot of research happening around us where we want to make a product with less material cost effective and with higher quality, a safe hygienic process product. So there is a lot of research happening. And if you are interested, if you got interested, if you enjoyed studying manufacturing process, you will also enjoy studying machine design, manufacturing management related course, computer aided design, engineering optimization, quality control, advanced composites, mechanical equipment design. So this is, this comma is wrong. It's a mistake. And a fracture mechanics. So some of these courses which are listed are elective courses. So you can adjust and opt for these courses if you enjoyed manufacturing process. I hope I cleared all the things. If you have any queries, do comment and I'll share the course handout in the description. Thank you.